Because you know how I am. I'm real. If you see me around here, I don't mean to say around.
You got to come and be on
film. Yeah, but I'm just saying, I'm not making, you know, funny or anything like that. There's no need to be broke back. What I'm saying is, you all got the truth already. You know, we're trying to enlighten those that don't have it.
Deuteronomy 32 and 8 again. The Most High divided to the nations their inheritance. When Deuteronomy 32 verse 8. When he separated the sons of Adam, he set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel as well. For the Lord's portion is his people.
The Lord's portion is his people.
Jacob is the Lord of his people.
Heritage. So there's a people in the Bible that has been chosen, okay, both all people and unto himself. So this is what this whole thing is about. This is about the truth of the matter of the Bible, because a lot of people have been taught that we're all equal like yourself. Got no disrespect. You got other people that's been in the church. Hear me out, hear me out, hear me out. You got other people in the church that have been taught the same thing. All nations can be saved according to what? There's no biblical reference. So if that's not in there, then that's a false statement. So we have to deal with the truth. Now I'm going to say this. The only way you can make it, because I'm going to be fair now. I'm not going to just say, oh, you're the devil. Now I'm going to say this now. You got our people that look like so-called white people. All right? You got the ones of our people that look like yourself. But if they're Israelites, they can be saved. Now let's say, for example, your forefathers go back to the so-called Negroes on the side. I can't say, no, you're not going to make it. A lot of them go back to the
Jewish traders.
You mean the Phoenician people? Okay, give me what you got.
It's an Amos 3 and 2. As Amos 3 and 1. Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel, against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt, saying, you only have I known of all the families of the earth.
The families of the whole earth. Because all of these people were all a big family, technically. Okay? We all come from one man by the name of Noah. Okay? And going further back, we all come out of Adam. So really, I'm your relatives. But at the same time, from amongst the families of the earth, what did the Lord choose his people? What does the scripture say? The scripture say, when you have two or three witnesses, right? Something like that to the effect of, if you have two or three witnesses, then that particular point, then the matter is established. So we found one to three or even more witnesses back in the second. You understand? So at the end of the day, we have to go by the witnesses. And these are the truths that we're going by. That's why the old states in Isaiah 29, where it says, precept upon precept, line upon line, here a little and there a little. And that's how we do. You know what I mean? We're not just saying, well, the Lord only chose the nation of Israel, and that's it. No, we're backing it up with the Bible.
I'm reading the book.
Honest here. Now, like I said, if you understand, because the bottom line is we can talk about other things on there, right? But the main thing in the matter is the main thing of the matter is now, okay, is the kingdom of heaven, okay? And who's gonna take part in the kingdom? Who's gonna take part in the kingdom of heaven?
I just pray heaven says on earth.
Well, I tell you what, you pray for this.
That's the idea.
Pray that the Heavenly Father reveals that you are on the sign. Now, if you're not a part of the sign here, hear me out. I gotta bring it up now. The truth of the matter is if you're not a part of the nation of Israel, then your people as a whole, the so-called Europeans, are gonna go into captivity because of what you've done to our people. Okay, and it's not just you, it's not just your people. All these other nations, they're going to be servants. Because all of the nations, they're going to be in the kingdom of heaven. But we're going to be the rulers of the kingdom of heaven based on the covenant that took place and other things and all that pencil. Okay, and that's what I'm about to say.
Maybe true, but I respect you very much for preaching it. Your
view, I
know.
It's the Howard Shah. Howard Shah,
I'm going to shake your hand as well. Okay, take it easy. Thanks for chatting. Bye.
I see slavery, man. That's all I gotta say. But, you know, hey, man, he's like, see, what we're all trying to do is come to the truth. No, man. It's you that's trying to come to the truth. We already got the truth already. That's the difference, and this is why we're out here, and he's not out here. Okay, why isn't he setting up some form of camp around the way? Because he doesn't have the truth. And you know what's funny about it is that a lot of these guys, a lot of these Israelites that come up talking about this more important thing. So like if they talk about this unification idea, or they have that idea of unification, it's because the media has been programming these people. Okay, the media has been programming these people to have that notion and have that idea so they can get ready for the one world order system. So if you want to start a new world order system, before you do that, guess what? You gotta plant a seed in the people's minds to believe that, okay, the causes of all of this chaos amongst races and all that, guess what, you gotta come together. So once they come together and they start the new world order agenda, it's not gonna be any form of hazard going on. Because people already have that one mind, that one world mindset. But what we believe is, we believe in totally, I think totally contrary to that. We believe that the Lord has created the nation of people whom he has chosen pursuant to the work, man. So what I want to do is, I'm gonna see if I can find something real quick. Because we believe in the Lord according to the record. You know, we believe in the Lord according to what is written. You know, we're not gonna go stand out here for hours and on end, you know, talking about what we feel should happen. Just go on a filibuster and rap. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna open these books up. And we're gonna give them the show. That's how we're gonna go. So the scripture I'm gonna get is John. And the thing about it is, and as well, it's like half of these Edomites, they believe that all of the other nations are not racist towards them. The they're trying to come on a level to where it's like, well, it's like, you guys, no, we're not racist. That's what their thing is, man, because see, they know that Jake is just simple. Jake will accept anybody and anything, man. But see, I'm gonna just become straight, man. You know, what the guys on the streets, the guys you see on the highways and the byways, man, okay? We're gonna just say this out loud and clear. Okay, we are racist, man. You know how we are racist? Because we are for our own people. That's why we racist, man. That's what the word racist means. It means for your own people. That's all it means. And everybody's racist, man. Everybody has some level of racism in them anyway. But we just got the balls to basically expose that, man. You understand? But I wanna, you know, get to the scripture that I have in mind. See, the difference between, you know, these regular black people that walk around is we know that all the other nations are full of shit. We know that. Okay, we know that we know that you don't like us anyway. Alright, so hey man, I'm just putting it out there. That's what I'm gonna say. So.
Well, that's usually the white cops that don't like you.
What's that?
It's usually the white cops that don't like you.
Well, it's not just them, mate. It's not just them. It's not just them, man. It's not just them.
No, it's just I have a black cousin. She's South Jamaican or something.
Right.
She nearly ended up my girlfriend. Thank goodness she wasn't. She was a cousin.
Right.
After what I see in the world, lived out on the street 23 years.
Right.
I've seen a lot.
I understand, man. I understand, but I know. I might be younger.
You see,
you
live in a nice little square box with a nice slanted roof, don't you?
Right, but I'm just saying, I know, I'm younger than you are, and it's obvious that I am a young man, but I do know this, is that the majority of the people don't like us, man. That's the truth. That's something that the majority of our people can't get into, because they don't want to accept that reality. You know, but I understand that you're going to have some people like yourself that, you know, might be up. Like the Irish and the Scots, we know about the Irish and the Scots and what issues they face. But what we're dealing with is the Bible. You know what I mean? We're not talking about just racism. We're dealing with the Bible. Now, you got a lot of the Irish or
you
know,
believing in the Bible and only believing the God Himself.
Now, hey, man, the Heavenly Father is in the Bible. There is a scripture we're supposed to
have. Yeah, but that's the past.
Yeah, I know.
That's the past, not future. That's not here and now. Right now and future, is it?
But you know what though, the Bible deals with the future too, my man. And we're living in biblical times. We just gotta look around.
I've been to Scotland and I've been to Wales and I've never seen a dragon yet. So I don't have to worry about Revelation, do I?
Well,
I don't have to worry about Revelation there, do I?
Hey man, all I can say is the Lord comes down, he's gonna bring destruction. There's gonna be a lot of destruction coming down, man. So the thing about that, when I see that,
before he brings destruction, I need to have a word with him.
Well,
my word is, why did he kill so many people when he said that? Why did he kill so many people? And then all of a sudden,
I'll tell you what you do. We'll explain that. See, he might be drunk. See, I like that. But at the end of the day, we can explain that to you why the Lord is doing this.
He drowned once, he drowned twice. Hang on. Did he or did he not? It says it in the Bible.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Matter of fact, brother, give me 1 Samuel 2 and 6. You're right, absolutely.
We had
right.
The flood, and then all of a sudden he asked Moses.
There's a reason why we had the flood.
Well, no, hang on. He still put the Ten Commandments there afterwards, yeah. So that don't make it.
But you know what though? We're gonna show you.
He hated us in the old place.
God is love now.
God is love now, is he?
Yeah, he's love. He is love. He works both ways, but we're gonna show you why he drowned all those people. Why he's going to continue to do more dirt to people. Give me
what makes one rule right doesn't make another rule right another.
I know
is that a
saying.
Fact? That's like me and you getting in trouble with the law, isn't it?
Right.
There's not one law for me and there's not one law for the other.
You know, though, there's a consequence to everything.
There's a consequence. Really? There is, man.
Like, for example?
Well, you know, I mean, I've been waiting 23 years.
I mean, let me hit you with something, man. I might be younger than you,
bro.
This is what it is. I'm gonna explain something to you, right? Now, when I was 10 years old, right? When I was growing up, when I was 10, yeah? I had my mates with me, and we picked up this one guy. Okay, he was like short and fat, whatever. And, you know, years down the line, when I went to the States, guess what? I was picked up. You understand? And that happens all the time. You see what I'm saying? So it's a thing called recompense. You understand? So everything has an effect. If you do positive things, there's a positive reaction. You understand? So there's a scripture that I want to get. Yeah, give me 1 Samuel 2. First Samuel.
Oh, you're not having a sandwich? No, but you can have the book from the States.
What's that book, man? What's this, man? Crossing the switch day. I'm gonna check this out. I'm gonna check it out.
Yeah, I met the gentleman, and the problem is my name is spelled differently to his. Got the same name, right. Same first name.
But a different last name.
But it's spelled differently.
Okay, okay.
He's got K-E-R. I've got I-N-O-S-O-N.
Alright, man, But you know what, though? You got that scripture, right?
So there we go.
That's our 1 Samuel.
Check this out.
The Lord killeth and maketh alive.
Like you said, the Lord killeth and maketh alive. Go on.
He bringeth down to the grave, yep. And bringeth up.
Go on.
The Lord maketh poor and maketh rich.
That's right. The Lord maketh poor and he maketh rich. So you're right. The Lord does kill. And he's going to do more.
Well, that was back straight away, wasn't it? He shouldn't have made us rich and he shouldn't have made us poor. Because all of a sudden, them people that are rich suddenly end up greedy.
No, but you know what it is, though?
And then poor, they're all of a sudden, they're going to go out greedy, and they're going to go out and rob everything. So I'll leave you alone tonight, lads. You're not ready for me.
No, stay right here. We like you, man. Honestly, we like you. I like your presence. I'm not going to lie. You know?
I mean, I don't see that you get many people who come up and argue a little bit of a case.
You know why? Because a lot of them ain't got no sense. You got sense. That's the difference. You give me
Ecclesiastes 3. Ecclesiastes 3, verse 15. Mm-hmm. That which hath been is now,
right.
And that which is to be have already been.
Yeah, go on.
And God requireth that which is past.
Yeah, go on.
And moreover, I saw under the sun the place of judgment.
Now you saw a place under the sun, a place of judgment.
That wickedness was there, and the place of righteousness and iniquity.
Right, the place of righteousness and iniquity was there. So, in other words, for example, let's look at the word judgment now. For example, okay, like, let's just go, this might go over your head a bit, but I'm going to just talk to you about it anyway. You might get it now. Let's say, for example, like, do you believe in, like, past lives and stuff like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
All right. I
know. Living one. Okay, well, we are past
I've been
lives.
In World War II, and I don't know why I was.
Well, there we go. That could have been human reincarnation, but the thing about this is now, for example.
Past life.
Absolutely. Hey, check this out. Now, like, for example, you see how certain people are born, right? Like, you know, you might have a baby that's born from limbs or anything of that nature. Like, you may think to yourself, how come that's happening? Like, what's the reason for that? The reason why that's happening is because that soul, okay, that soul that's in the baby, the body of the baby, right? It's the same spirit, but that spirit is something wicked in his past life to get judged in the second lifetime, okay? That's why it tells you, I think it's Exodus, the third, Exodus 24 says, to the third and to the fourth generation that hate to be, okay? Because you got a generation. We had a generation at the time of Israelites that was always bucking up against the Lord, okay? And didn't want to follow his commandments. But that same generation is here today to get judged, okay? That's how it works. So when you come back on the earth, you might come back in a situation where you can't live. You can't even have a shoe from. You
ain't
got no
rest.
Okay, you gotta be in a
wheelchair. Or you might, it could be any form of lifestyle.
It could be a thing where you could be brought up where your mom, you know, she's not really, you know, she's basically been sleeping around different men. She hasn't raised you the right way, man. But that happens. These are all
judgments that are played on me.
That's why I've been in jail for it.
But there it is.
It wasn't big, it wasn't clever to me.
But there it is. But if you're an Israelite, I'm going to say this, if you're an Israelite, which a lot of the Irish are, the Lord is going to provide all of us. The Lord is going to provide all of us. That's why I'm telling you, I'm going to show you
about the trumpet.
Yeah, you're going.
Amos 3:6, shall a trumpet be blown in the city, and the people not be afraid? Shall there be evil in the city, and the Lord have not done it?
Yes, sir. Shall there be evils in the city? Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. And it shall come to pass that thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments, which I command thee this day. The Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
That's right. So that was our blessing to begin with.
So don't we need the question of why were the Ten Commandments not given to us? The God of the rain in the first place.
Well, really, because the Lord has a time and a prayer. Well, really, the Lord's were back then.
That's why they knew about sacrificing Cain and Abel. They always did about sacrifices. God refused Abel, and he refused Cain, and they accepted Abel's offering because they knew about sacrificial law. They understood it, but it wasn't written down. During the time of Moses,
Genesis 4,
it was written down. The laws were written down during the time of Moses, but before them, it was all oral. It was all oral done. That's why we knew that homosexuality was an abomination. During the time of Sodom and Gomorrah.
Look at the package.
During the time of Sodom, we didn't need no written law to tell us that. We just knew it based on oral law.
Sleeping with each other's family. And
yeah, we knew that, you had Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. They did what was right in the eyes of them. It wasn't homosexuals. They wasn't eating abominable. There was in line with the Most High because it was all oral law. It was all oral law that was given to them. Okay, it's only hundreds of years later, during the time of Moses, that the Most High had given the law written down.
Yeah, he's going to read it to you to get Genesis 4 for the
moment. That's Genesis 4 and 1. And Adam knew Eve, his wife, and she conceived and bare Cain, and said, I have gotten a man from the Lord. And she again bare his brother Abel, and Abel was a keeper of sheep, but Cain was a tiller of the ground.
See that it says that Abel was a keeper of the sheep. So he obviously sacrificed for a lamb. Okay, a lamb is more like a sheep. Right, so according to the laws, sacrificing laws, that's what those are one of the animals that you can sacrifice.
Right. Sheep, a goat.
Right.
There was some other
cooking up a ram.
Cow. The cow went as well.
The ox,
it's a cow.
Right. Yes, go on. But it said that Cain was what, a tiller of the ground?
And Abel was the keeper of sheep,
right.
And Cain was a tiller of the ground.
So Abel was basically a shepherd.
Hang on. We need to balance things out here. Yeah, you need to balance things out here. You don't kill one, kill a little bit of the other. Don't kill all of one, and don't kill all of the other. Hang on, what have you got? Yes? Yeah? So you don't kill all of one, and you didn't kill all of other.
What are you trying to say?
What I'm trying to say is they're both out of balance. It's like me doing your garden now, yeah? Right, I need to kill the weeds, but I don't need to kill the grass. Yeah? I need to kill one, keep the balance right, keep it straight, yeah? Everything needs to be perfect.
So there's a balance.
The balance is great, isn't it?
right, there was a balance. So one was accepted and one wasn't accepted.
As far as I'm concerned, one was a goal and the other one was a goal.
Yeah, there were. One was wrong, one was right. Because when you read on the
And this process of time, it came to pass that Cain brought of the fruit of the ground an offering unto the Lord.
So Cain brought the fruit of the ground as an offering to the Lord. Let's find out if God accepted that offering.
And Abel and Abel, he also brought of the firstlings of his flock and of the fat thereof.
Right, so he brought the firstlings of his flock, a lamb, okay? Alright, but his brother Abel brought the fruit of the ground, go ahead.
And the Lord had respect unto Abel and to his offering.
So the Lord had respect unto Abel, the one that brought the lamb, go ahead.
Right, I'm going to walk away rather quickly, throw this in rather quickly. What happens with nature? Most of nature, when it comes towards animals, is like a fucking rabbit. Yeah? So when you kill that fucking grass off, yeah? Then all of a sudden you've had God knows how many sleeping rabbits still in between. So when you just killed that one, the others that you didn't kill are still running around and they're fucking getting pregnant. So, and that's before the grass has even grown and the fruit has even grown out of the tree. Have a good day.
But you know that we want you to stick around because we still gonna show you more things.
I can't stick around, mate.
Okay, just one more scripture then.
One more scripture.
Yeah, one more scripture, man.
It's just I've got to get my head down. I'm homeless, mate. So.
Oh no,
that's one of them life things.
Yeah, but you know, like I was saying before about you know the right and the wrong.
Yeah, that's what you're right. Yeah, that's what you're right. That's your brother right there.
No, but the thing about it is that there's a right and a wrong. There's always a right and a wrong. And for example, the reason why the Lord is going to kill loads of people on this side again is because of the maximum of sin that's going on. Okay, the wrong things are going on. One more scripture. Give me 2 Ezra 15. Yeah. Here we go.
I'd like to catch me here again. It's just when I'm on the drink and not when I am. I mean, I'm asleep.
Oh, for real, man.
That's because I've been off that.
Oh, man. Yeah, I think it's verse 1.
And that isn't the answer either, so.
And I think it's Ezra.
You're gonna stop, man. You're gonna get some sleep.
That's what I'd like.
2 Ezra 15 and 1. Behold, speak thou in the ears of my people the words of prophecy, which I will put in their mouth. Said the Lord,
which is what we've been doing for a long time now, go on.
And cause them to be written in paper, for they are faithful and true. Fear not the imagination against thee, let not the incredulity of them trouble thee.
Yeah, meaning the unbelief. People come up there and they scoff up against what we're saying and all of that against them, but we don't care about that, because we understand that these scriptures are true. And we see part of the prophecies of this Bible coming to pass the other day. Go on.
That speak against it. For all the unfaithful shall die in their unfaithfulness. Behold, said the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction.
Like he did during the time of the flood. Yeah. But the difference is this flood is going to be by nuclear fire, because you're going to have a World War III going. But what's going to lead up to all of that is the different plagues and the diseases going.
For wickedness have exceedingly polluted the whole earth,
right.
And their hateful works are fulfilled.
Like for example, the brother was going into, you got people now, they know that they have to do certain things that are right, but they choose not to do it. So what's the consequence for all of this wickedness that's been going on? Has to be done away. So it's like, for example, you got a house, right? And you just don't even take care of the garbage, right? All of that garbage is going to pile up, and your house is going to be restored, man. And then you're not going to be able to live in the house. You're going to have bugs all over the place and all that dissonance. So what the Lord is going to do, the Lord is going to take care of his house, okay, and do away with the nastiness that's going on this planet. That's why he's going through the killing. But there's going to come a time and a place. Go on, I'll let the brother be on.
Behold, saith the Lord, I will bring plagues upon the world, the sword, famine, death, and destruction. For wickedness has exceedingly polluted the whole earth, and their hateful works are fulfilled. Therefore, saith the Lord, I will hold my tongue no more as touching to their wickedness,
he's going to act on it,
which they prevailingly commit, neither will I suffer them in those things in which they wickedly exercise themselves. Behold, the innocent and the righteous
blood. That's going into something else, but that's just, that's the reason on why you're going to have great death on the planet. But like I said before, and this society gets destroyed because we're living in an actual empire. When this empire gets destroyed, the kingdom of our Lord and our Savior is going to be revived, which is called the kingdom of God, okay, or the kingdom of heaven. Once this kingdom is established, there's going to be peace forever and ever, as it tells you in many different scriptures. How is the earth going to be at peace forever? Because we're going to do the right thing, and we're going to keep those universal laws, which is in the Bible, okay, which is the manuscript of the earth. Therefore, there's not going to be no reason for evilness or wickedness. But the reason why this world is in the shit because you have a nation of people or a group of people that's running the earth and destroying it and not keeping the laws. But there will be peace though. Eventually there will be peace. That's all I gotta say, man.
Give you the one to think about. Yeah? Here's on evolution. Yourself. Right? Everything goes from somewhere, yes?
That's right.
Spider, stupid fly, me, you.
All that came from the Most High.
Octopus, fish in the sea.
Right.
Yeah? Can you believe in one person?
Only if he's coming in the right spirit.
One person. Hang on.
That one person. That's what
it takes two. It takes two. It takes two. It always takes two. Yeah? Finally, take an example from my mother and my brother-in-law. Right? They jump into bed with each other. It takes two to do tango, yes?
Of course. Of course, to make a family it takes two.
Where'd you come from? He has to come from a family somewhere.
But guess what? The scripture says
he has to come from a seed and somewhere. He has to come from a seed.
Well, but guess what?
It's a fact.
Guess what? He's the ancient of days. You know what that means?
No, no. Because it's not a fact in there.
Matter of fact, one more scripture, bro. Give me Daniel's 10. Give me Daniel's 10. Because he's the ancient of days, meaning he has no end and he has no beginning. Okay, so we're not going to go to that point because we can't fathom that. That's not in our comprehension. So we're going to do.
Why is it not in our comprehension?
Because
we don't have that information. We had a female that bit that fruit. We know knowledge. We know everything.
It's Daniel's 10 and 5.
We know everything. It says so in the Bible.
Yeah, well, I mean, what we know in part. We know.
No, it doesn't say in part. It says what we know in everything.
All I can say is this, the Heavenly
That's
Father.
That's what it says in the Bible.
The Heavenly Father is without things.
Is it in Genesis?
That's Daniel 10 and 5. Then I lifted up my eyes and looked, and behold, a certain man clothed in linen, whose loins were girded with fine gold of ephah. His body also was like beryl, and his face as the appearance of lightning.
Yeah, that's talking about the Lord.
And his eyes as the lamp of fire, and his arms and his feet like in Tala, polished brass.
Yeah, he was a dark skinned man.
And the voice of his voice like the voice of a mouth shoot.
Uh-huh.
And I, Daniel, alone saw the vision.
Just one more scripture, you can do what you gotta do. Go on.
But the men there were with me.
Right, so yeah, not the vision. Like, yeah, I'll be ready for it. I'm good at this, you know. I'm clever. No, I'm not clever.
But a great weapon fell upon them.
You got enough sense to debate with us now, I'm saying that.
Yes, I have.
So that they failed. So,
and
so
it's good
to hide themselves.
As long as there's no peace to come, nothing or anything. Right. It's just mad.